وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We stopped at where the author rahimahullah said in the kitab Akhlaaq Hamalati Al-Quran. He said, أحمده على قديم إحسانه وتواتر نعمه حمد من يعلم أن مولاه الكريم علمه ما لم يكن يعلم. The author here, he says, the praise that I'm praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is the praise of the one who knows. أَنَّ مَوْلَاهُ, that is master, الْكَرِيمُ, the generous master, عَلَّمَهُ, he taught him, مَا لَمْ يَكُنْ يَعْلَمْ, that which he didn't know. From the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon me, the author is saying, that I am showing gratitude and I'm praising my Lord for, is that he has taught me that which I didn't know. And the author is taking this from the ayah, وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. Your Lord taught you, Muhammad, that which he didn't know. وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. And the blessings of your Lord, and the virtue that your Lord has bestowed upon you is vast. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if that was said to the Prophet, then definitely the same is for us as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he taught us that which we never knew. Every day we're learning new things. Who is the one that is giving us the ability to comprehend and understand and learn from life experiences, gain Islamic knowledges, gain academic sciences? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك, understanding this blessing and really comprehending it is truly a sign of iman. ولذلك, in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, أَبُؤُ لَكَ بِنِعْمَتِكَ عَلَيَّ. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm showing you gratitude for the blessings that you have bestowed upon you. So the person should be an individual who does that. وَكَانَ فَضْلُهُ عَلَيْهِ عَظِيمًا, and his blessings and virtues on him are vast. So he's taking it from the ayah. It's an iqtibas from the ayah. وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا, is where he took it from. وَأَسْأَلُهُ, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala الْمَزِيدَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for extra and more of his virtues. It's what I ask for, the author is saying. We want more from him. And as I said to you before, the blessings of Allah are two types. A blessing that's already there, and a blessing that is missing from you. So he's saying, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessings that you have given to us, we are thankful for it. And we also want more. And I mentioned the ayah, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكَ أَمَا وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in this verse that if we show gratitude to the blessings of Allah, that He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will increase it for us. So the author is asking Allah for more blessings. وَأَسْأَلُهُ, I ask Him, أَلْمَزِيدَ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ وَالشُّكْرَ, and gratitude, عَلَى مَا تَفَضَّلَ بِهِ مِنْ نِعَمِهِ, and I show gratitude on that which he has bestowed subhanahu wa ta'ala from his blessings. إِنَّهُ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? He is one that has large, great, vast amount of virtue subhanahu wa ta'ala. لذلك, this is similar to a statement that Imam Shafi'i said in the beginning of his kitab al-Risala. He said, Alhamdulillahi alladhi, praises to Allah, the one, لا يؤدى شكره نعمة من نعمه إلا بنعمة منه توجب على مؤدي ماضي نعمه بأدائها نعمة حادثة يجب عليه شكره بها. This statement of the author here is similar to a statement of Imam Shafi'i that he mentions in the muqaddimah of his kitab al-Risala. And that is, the author here is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him the ability to show gratitude, okay? And showing gratitude to Allah is a blessing itself from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that come from him. And author Shafi'i mentions something similar to that in his kitab al-Risala. The author then says, وَصَلَّ عَلَىٰ سَيِّدِنَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَىٰ be on who? عَلَىٰ سَيِّدِنَا our master مُحَمَّدٍ نبي الله محمد عَبْدِهِ his slave وَرَسُولِهِ and his messenger. نبي الله محمد, his station and his level is in these two words, which is that he is a abd, a slave, and he's a messenger. He's not an ordinary slave. He's a messenger. But he's not a divine lord that is worshipped. He's not a god that is worshipped. He's not an ilah that is worshipped. He's a slave. But he's not an ordinary slave. We don't treat him like us. He's better than us. He's higher than us. Then that is the station that we give him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We put him up than an ordinary slave. And we also put him lower than reaching the level of uluhiyya. We're never going to believe he's an ilah that's worshipped. Okay? وَأَمِينِهِ عَلَىٰ وَحْيِهِ وَعِبَادِهِ The Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was entrusted with what? The revelation. Allah trusted the Prophet ﷺ with the revelation. Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalata. Allah knows who is going to give the message to. And Allah chose him. He was chosen ﷺ for this message. And Allah also entrusted him to convey it to his slaves. That was something Allah entrusted him with, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salatan takunu lahu ridan wa lana biha maghfirah. I send, he said, salutation upon our Prophet, our Sayyid, our Master, Muhammad, the slave of Allah and the Messenger of Allah. His Prophet, the one Allah entrusted with the revelation to convey to the creation. Salatan, peace. Takunu lahu ridan, that will be for him, rida, that which will be pleasing for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَنَا بِهَا and for us it will be مَغْفِرَةٌ a forgiveness. يعني the salah that I'm asking for the Prophet, it's that which is going to bring him happiness and contentment. And it's also going to be for us what? Forgiveness, the author is saying. وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ and the Prophet's family. أَجْمَعِينَ all of them. All of the Prophet's family, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Since the author didn't say وَصَحْبِي and his companions, we believe that the Sahabas are now under the Alihi. They're falling under the Alihi in this place. وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ his family and his companions. أَجْمَعِينَ all of them. The word Salah, what is the correct opinion regarding it? The word Salah, the strongest opinion regarding it is that it means Allah praises the Prophet in the gathering of the angels. Allah praises him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَلَّمَ كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا سَلَامْنَا means what? Salam means peace. Okay? كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا كَثِيرًا means large and a lot and طَيِّبًا means good. أَمَّا بَعْدُ to proceed. And the scholars, they differed amongst themselves who was the first person to say أَمَّا بَعْدُ. Who was the first person to say أَمَّا بَعْدُ? Some of the scholars actually said that the first person to actually say Amma Ba'du was Nabiullah Dawood. And it's what Allah referred to in the Qur'an as وَآتَيْنَاهُ فَصْلَ الْخِطَابِ We gave him Dawood فَصْلَ الْخِطَابِ يعني Amma Ba'du. Some scholars said that. And Allah knows best. فَإِنِّي قَائِلٌ The author says, I'm going to say here. I'm going to say what? I'm going to say here, وَبِاللَّهِ أَثِقُ, and in Allah I trust. لِتَوْفِيقِ الصَّوَابِ, that Allah gives me the ability in getting it right. مِنَ الْقَوْلِ, in speech. وَالْعَمَلِ, in action. وَلَا قُوَّةَ, there is no strength. إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, except in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الْعَلِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ, the one who is high and the one who is great. Okay? إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ, except in Allah. الْعَلِيِّ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, the ulu that he has is three types. Uluwu dhatin, he Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is above his throne. Uluwu qahrin, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he is powerful over his creation. He has the control over his creation. And the third one is uluwu qadrin, which is Allah is station wise and position wise. He's greater than his creation. We can never equal Allah to the creation. He's station is greater than the station of the creation. So, إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ. أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ, Allah sent down. الْقُرْآنَ, Allah sent down the Qur'an. عَلَى نَبِيِّهِ صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah sent the Qur'an down on his prophet. يعني نبي الله محمد. Allah sent it down. The author is going to bring many verses for that, inshallah ta'ala. وَأَعْلَمَهُ فَضْلَ مَا أَنْزَلَ عَلَيْهِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he taught the prophet the virtue of what he has sent on him. وَأَعْلَمَ خَلْقَهُ فِي كِتَابِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala educated the creation in the virtue of the Qur'an and how virtuous it is. وَعَلَى لِسَانِ رَسُولِهِ, and also on the tongue of the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah told us and mentioned to us the virtue and the position of the Qur'an. أَنَّ الْقُرْآنَ عِصْمَةٌ لِمَنِ اعْتَصَمَ بِهِ, that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala taught us about the virtue of the Qur'an, and the Prophet told us of the virtue of the Qur'an, is that anyone who holds on to the Qur'an, he's going to be infallible. يعني he's going to be far from mistakes and errors. If you want to be errorless, and if you want to not do a mistake, then follow the Qur'an. When you fall into a mistake is when you turn away from the Qur'an. That's what Allah said in the Qur'an, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَى وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ, anyone who follows the guidance, يعني the Qur'an, and also the sunnah, what will not happen to him? What isn't going to happen to you is that you're not going to be misguided in this earth, and in the hereafter, you're not going to be from the dwellers of the hellfire. That's not going to happen to you. Also, by holding on to the Qur'an is what? Wahuda, it's guidance. لِمَنِ اهْتَدَى بِهِ, the person who takes it as a guidance. The Qur'an will guide you, as Allah said in the Qur'an, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. Allah mentions here, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ, the Qur'an guides you to the best of affairs. وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and the Qur'an, وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and the Qur'an guides what? The believers, which ones? الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ, the ones that do righteous actions. The believers who are consistent in doing righteous actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned, أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا, for them is what? أجر, reward, كَبِيرًا, vast reward, a lot of reward is for them. So they're not just people who merely say, I believe. But what they did is, they coupled with their statement of saying, I believe, they coupled it with righteous actions. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ, those who are doing righteous actions. Righteous actions means is done with sincerity, and it's also done in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you do that, the Qur'an is going to guide you to the best of affairs. Yani this Qur'an, a group of people read it, and all they take from it is what? Misguidance, confusion, ha. And another group of people read the Qur'an and they take guidance and bliss and prosperity and tranquility. Because the Qur'an, it guides the believers. Yani the believers, when they come to the Qur'an, they come with an open heart and mind. They know that their salvation, they know their happiness, they know their prosperity, they know their bliss is all connected to this book. مَنْ أَرَادَ الدُّنْيَا فَلْيَتَعَلَّمِ الْقُرْآنِ. Anyone who wants the dunya, learn the Qur'an. وَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْآخِرَةِ فَلْيَتَعَلَّمِ الْقُرْآنِ. The one who wants akhirah, learn the Qur'an. وَمَنْ أَرَادَهُمَا. Anyone who wants both of them, يعني دنيا والآخرة, فَلْيَتَعَلَّمِ الْقُرْآنِ. Let him learn the Qur'an. يعني the Qur'an, it will give you the best in this dunya, and it will give you the best of the hereafter, and it will also give you the best of both worlds. You see? ولذلك this ayah, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا. I encourage you all to go to the kitab أضواء البيان في إيضاح القرآن بالقرآن by العلامة محمد الأمين الشنقيطي رحمه الله. In the tafsir of this ayah, subhanallah, the Shaykh, he went deeply into it. And he showed how the Qur'an guides to the best of affairs. Yani the Shaykh, he went in details. So go to it. It's in Surah Al-Isra, Ayah 9. Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti proved that the Qur'an guides in the best of affairs, in Tawheed, in our marital issues, in our economical issues, in the rights of men and women, yani in the animal rights. Yani in every field, the Qur'an guides us to the best of affairs. But when we've become distanced from the Qur'an and we abandon the Qur'an and we toss the Qur'an over our shoulders, we are in the current state that we're in. You see, we are in the current state that we're in. So we need to turn back to the Qur'an, look for guidance in it. And a lot of us, subhanAllah, when we come to the Qur'an, we come to the Qur'an with a preconceived notion. And we read the Qur'an as though we want the Qur'an to bend to our desires. We want the Qur'an to follow us. We want the Qur'an to do what we want, and not the reverse way, which is that the Qur'an is the thing that we need to be following. It's the Qur'an that we need to be taking its way. So this is important. وَغِينًا, the Qur'an brings richness. لِمَنِ اسْتَغْنَى بِهِ. If you take the Qur'an and you live by the Qur'an, Allah is going to bring you richness. And you're going to feel contentment. Even if you have little money. Even if you have little money and you don't have much, the Qur'an will bring richness to you. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ الْبُخَارِي and Muslim both narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us that the children of Adam, nothing can actually fill them up. The Prophet said, لَوْ كَانَ لِبْنِ آدَمْ, if it was for the children of Adam, وَادٍ مِّن ذَهَبٍ, if they had a valley of gold, if the children of Adam was to have a valley of gold, يعني, subhanAllah, whole entire valley of gold, أَحَبَّ أَنَّ لَهُ وَادِيًا آخَرًا, the person would wish he had another valley of gold. He's got one valley of gold, he'll say, I wish I. And he, subhanAllah, I once met a brother who was a millionaire. And he said, I wish I had 2 million. And he's got a million. He said, I wish I had 2 million. But I said, you got a million. The children of Adam, that's how they are. Have you ever seen in your life, have you ever come across a person who said, you know what, I'm rich, I don't want no more money. That's it. I don't want no more money. Have you ever seen anyone say that? You see, that's the problem with the children of Adam. لَوْ كَانَ لِبْنِ آدَمَ, if it was for the children of Adam, وَادٍ مِّن ذَهَبٍ, if he had a valley of gold, the thing he would want and he would desire is أَحَبَّ أَنَّ لَهُ وَادِيًا آخَرًا, he would wish he had another valley. وَلَنْ يَمْلَأَ, the Prophet said there's nothing that's going to fill. فَاهُ, the mouth of the children of Adam, there's nothing else that's going to fill it. إِلَّا التُرَابُ, except the dust and the sand. That's the only thing that's going to fill the mouth and the stomach of the children of Adam. وَاللَّهُ يَتُوبُ عَلَى مَنْ تَابُ, and Allah accepts the repentance of the one who repents. So what we learn from this is that, brothers and sisters, what is the only thing that can make your heart content? يعني if dinar and dirham cannot actually make you content, يعني money, however rich you are, you won't be happy necessarily. Money doesn't necessarily bring happiness. That's important you understand it. Like in the Qur'an, it brings you happiness. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Verily, in the remembrance of your Lord, does the heart find tranquility. Yani you find tuma'nina, as-sakina, tranquility. You see, how many people have we heard or read or seen or come across who were rich, extremely rich, but they committed suicide. And they chose to leave this world. They had everything. They had wealth, they had money, they had properties, they had commodities, they had businesses, they had everything. Ma'adhalik, they wanted to die. They didn't want to live this life anymore. The reason is because their heart, the heart dehydrated. And once the heart dehydrates, my beloved brothers and sisters, suicidal thoughts. The person doesn't want to live anymore. He wants to leave this world. So the Qur'an brings richness. وَحِرْزٌ مِنَ النَّارِ لِمَنِ اتَّبَعَهُ لِمَنِ اتَّبَعَهُ. The Qur'an is a hirz. It's a fortress. مِنَ النَّارِ, from the hellfire. Hirz. It protects you. The Qur'an. It's a waqin مِنَ النَّارِ وَجُنَّةِ. It's a shield from the hellfire. لِمَنِ اتَّبَعَهُ, the one who follows it. If you follow the Qur'an is a shield that protects you from the hellfire. It will. You will not enter the hellfire. It will protect you from it. وَنُورٌ, the Sheikh says, it's a light. لِمَنِ اسْتَنَارَ بِهِ, the person who takes this Qur'an as a light. The Qur'an is a light. That's what Allah says in many places. وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُبِينًا. We have sent on you, وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ, we have sent on all of you guys, نُورًا مُبِينًا, a clear light. Also in another ayah, Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ أُوحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَأُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. نُورًا. Allah referred to the Qur'an as what? Light. When other people are in darknesses and they are lost and blind and they can't see where they are walk, where they're walking towards. The person of the Qur'an, he is upon what? نُورٌ عَلَى نُورٍ يَهْدِي اللَّهُ لِنُورِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. You are upon light upon light. That's what you have. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. The Qur'an is a what? The Qur'an is a cure. It's a cure. The Qur'an cures. And it cures the person from the two types of illnesses there are. مَرَضِ الشُّبْهَةِ وَمَرَضِ الشَّهْوَةِ. It cures you from the illnesses of desires. And it also cures you from the illnesses of doubts. And if you open this Qur'an, if you read this Qur'an, it will remove any doubt in your heart. Yani the doubt of shirk and disbelief of Allah and atheism and being agnostic. And if you read the Qur'an, it will eradicate all of that. And it will get rid of all of that. The Qur'an will do that. It will also cure the desires, the shahwa, that's burning inside the person. The Qur'an has cure for it. It has a what? It has cures for it. وَلِذَلِكَ, that's why Allah said in the Qur'an, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ الشِّفَاءَ. We have sent down the Qur'an as a cure. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Some of the scholars, some of the people more like, have understood from that the Qur'an is not a cure in its entirety. So they said, no, the whole Qur'an is not a cure. Because Allah said in the ayah, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. From the Qur'an, we have made a cure. Yani from the Qur'an, not all of the Qur'an. And this is wrong and a weakness on the side of the person who is commenting on this verse. What we say is, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. This min here, it's not tab'idiyah. It's not some of the Qur'an. It's bayanu lil-jins. Ibn al-Qayyim mentions it in his kitab, Al-Jawabul Kafi. Or in his other kitab, Al-Da'wa Dawa, whichever one of those names you want to call it. So it's important that you understand this point, inshallah ta'ala. So what does it mean here? It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down the Qur'an as a cure. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًا, and the Qur'an is a guidance. وَرَحْمَةٌ, and it's a mercy. For who? لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, for the believers. The Qur'an is a guidance. Guidance, what does it mean? It means that the Qur'an guides to two things. This is very important. The Quran is guidance, like in guiding us to what? Beneficial knowledge and righteous action. That's what the Quran is guiding us. Every moment we read the Quran, it's teaching us new information. And also, what is that the Quran is guiding us to? The Quran is guiding us to righteous action, that we perfect our actions and we learn to come with more and more actions. But we couple our actions with beneficial knowledge as well. So we don't just become a people who are doing things, but we don't have no knowledge. Or we don't become a people who have knowledge and understanding, but we don't implement what we've learned or understood. وَرَحْمَةٌ, and it's a mercy. وَرَحْمَةٌ here means what? The beneficial knowledge and the righteous actions that you have come with, Allah is going to give you His mercy in what? In taking you to Jannah. Because we can't enter Jannah because of our own actions. The Sahabas, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to them, لَنْ يَدْخُلَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْجَنَّةَ بِعَمَلِي. None of you are going to enter Jannah because of his actions. And then the Sahabas, they said, قِيلَ وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Even you, O Messenger of Allah. The Prophet said, even me. إِلَّا أَيَتَغَمَّدَنِي اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنْهُ وَفَضْلًا. Unless Allah bestows His mercy upon me, there is no other way for me to enter Jannah. So you having beneficial knowledge and righteous action is not enough to take you to Jannah. It has to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. I'm going to stop there, inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.